Steve Bowers and
Cassandra Fuller.
Welcome you to Six in the City. Before we get to the show, just a big congratulations. We have four football teams from this city that are still in the playoffs.
Right.
JCM will be at Milan Friday night, and let's see, and Trinity's on the road to Columbia. Two games at home, Jackson Christian hosts Franklin Grace, and USJ hosts Battleground Academy. And we'll have the championship games December 5th, 6th, and 7th right here live at EPlus
TV6.
That's
right, EPlus TV6.
But good luck to all our teams that are still left in the playoffs.
Ooh-wee, we got a full studio today.
We do today.
We're going to be Zooming with Zach Willis. He's over in Union City at Discovery Park. This weekend is their Let It Glow kickoff. We're going to find out about that and find out just how many lights they're talking about. Nikki Gano is here. She's Director of Operations with Habitat for Humanity, and she brought with her Hannah Gary. She's the office manager there because they've got a couple of things they want to talk about, but the main thing is their Dream Builders 2024 New Year's Eve
celebration. Here we go.
And George Googe is here, so you know what that means. It's time for the fall concert for the Jackson Area Community Bands, and David Kiles is with him. He's the conductor of the Swing Orchestra.
All right.
Got lots of great music that's coming up, so you want to stick around for that. Annette Graves is here. She is local chair of the Do the Right Thing program, which is part of a national campaign to stop violence. She has a couple of students with her, the National Student Ambassador Charlotte Mount and Josiah Young.
Yeah.
So we're going to hear something from their essays.
Hear about their trip.
That's right, and their trip. And then our entertainment is going to be talking to us today. So
right.
We get two doses of him.
Four segments with...
Memphis Jones.
Glad to have him with us.
Excited to have him back on the show. He's been a couple of times, but it's been a while. Good to have him back.
Before we get to show a couple other community notes, the Choral Society's program Seasons is this coming Saturday at 4 at First Baptist. And the Veterans Parade, last week, scheduled for this coming Saturday. We'll start at 11.
That's right. Food Truck Friday's right around the corner, too.
Food Truck Friday as well.
This week.
All right. Set and ready?
Yes, we are.
Let's go with this.
Six in the City.
I'm Mark Taylor. I'm the owner of Renew Biomedical Services based out of here in Jackson, Tennessee. We're a provider of biomedical services for medical professionals. At Renew Biomedical, our use of telecom is of utmost importance. We have to reach our customers in a timely fashion so we can diagnose and service their equipment needs. So EPlus Broadband allows Renew Biomedical to connect effectively with our customers in whichever way they choose, via email, phone, Skype, teleconferencing, and any way you can imagine.
Every child follows a path in life. For many, that path will lead them to a door that gives them a place to grow, to learn, to belong, a place to forge their future. Because while many doors open, these doors transform. They did for us. Support your local Boys and Girls Clubs. Great futures start here.
Honey, what I think you need is a socket wrench.
I play JV basketball.
I'm sorry. I don't think it looks right.
This is good, and it's all good, baby.
Is it really all good?
If you love me enough to routinely test your handyman skills, not to mention the strength of your marriage, then of course you'll visit nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure I'm in the right car seat.
I'm gonna call my dad.
All right, let's begin this Six in the City in Union City.
That's right.
Zach Willis is with us.
Just like that.
Public Relations with Discovery Park of America. Zach, good to have you here.
Good to see you, Zach.
Nice to see you guys.
Nice to meet you. All right, great to have you with us. Well,
you've been talking to him.
You know the things are coming up. We got a bunch of lights that we're about to turn loose.
Well, I think so. Tell us about it, Zach. Tell us what's happening this weekend.
That's right. We do love Thanksgiving around here, but the pumpkins are gone, and it is very much beginning to look a lot like Christmas at Discovery Park.
Oh, quick question. Side note to that. What do you do with all those pumpkins?
I'll have to get back to you on that. Our grounds director was trying to get a lot of us to take those home.
I still see some around every now and then.
I bet so.
That was just a side question.
Go ahead.
What we got going on?
Well, our Let It Glow kickoff is actually this Friday, November 15th. The doors open at 5 p.m. and the kickoff starts at 6 p.m. Our CEO, Scott Williams, will be the MC for the event this year. The kickoff ceremony will feature performances by the Voices of Union City Elementary and a Jackson Symphony Ensemble with Sabrina Warren.
Oh, wow. The symphony's coming to Union City. That's great news.
That's right. I hear Santa Claus might be as well.
Ooh.
So this will all start what time this Saturday? Exactly.
Oh, well, the doors open at 5, but it starts at 6 p.m.
6 p.m. Is there a fee for this, Zach?
For members, the kickoff is free, and the drive-through is actually free for members on November 15th only as well. Typically, the drive-through is $10 per vehicle, and the walk-through is $5 per person. It's free for ages 3 and under.
Okay. All right. Well, what's the best way to see it? Should we drive through? Should we walk through? Should we just go in and do both?
I would recommend doing both, absolutely.
I figured you would say that.
So this starts the 15th, and what is the schedule then for the rest of this season?
So it goes from November 15th to December 30th. It'll be closed on Thanksgiving Day or Thanksgiving night, Christmas Eve night, and Christmas night. Other than that, even though we're closed, the museum is closed on Mondays right now. It's even open on Mondays from the 15th to December 30th, 6 to 9 every night. Okay. 5 to 9 every night, sorry.
5 to 9 every night. Okay. You said you had something else that was coming up right around the corner, though, before this, right?
Actually, after it.
After, okay.
Next Thursday, the 21st, is our next Beyond the Brush event. It's actually an adult-only one as well, and it's a pretty cool, and we've only done two adult. This will be a second adult-only one this year, and this is going to be in Cooper Tower from 4 to 6:30 p.m. Guests will get to paint the sunset as it's happening.
Oh, nice. Okay.
As good best, girls' night.
As best they can, right?
Or good date night or girls' night out night or whatever, right?
Yes.
Okay. And how much is that, Zach?
It is 20 for members and 30 for non-members. You can visit our website and go to the calendar page, and it'll have a link to ticket purchasing.
Okay, and we keep talking about members, so what's a membership fee there?
Oh, man, give me a second. I can tell you, individual membership is $50.
Okay.
But really, the family memberships are, that's our best one.
Best value.
To get.
And people can go online to get that, right?
That's right. You can go to become a member at Discovery Park, and okay. So two adults is 140, one adult and one child is 110, two adults and up to four children is 179. Okay.
What does that membership get you then?
Yeah.
Get you free admission to Discovery Park any day of the year.
Okay.
Unlimited trips up to the Cooper Tower. And we do member-only events throughout the year as well.
For people who don't know, Zach, what's the Cooper Tower?
So Cooper Tower is our 199-foot tower at Discovery Park.
The and one that you, the one you can see from miles away, yeah.
That's correct.
Yeah, okay. All right. Well, it's the Let It Glow kickoff coming up this weekend.
This weekend, the 15th.
That's right.
Discovery Park.
Right. Over what? Over a million lights? Is that what you told us?
Yes, our grounds director, John Watkins, told me it's definitely over a million lights. He said if you take all the strands of lights, that it would be as long as 24 to 25 miles long.
Oh, wow.
Well, check out Discovery Park of America for all the details. Zach, it's good to have you with us.
It is. Good to meet you, Zach.
Thank you, guys.
When we come back, we'll be talking about New Year's Eve.
That's right. Already.
On this, Six in the City.
I'm Dr. Keith H. Taylor, owner and CEO of the Mid-South Dental Implant and Oral Surgery Center. Our clinic is unique because it offers oral surgery suites, general dentistry suites, as well as a fully run operating room. EPlus Broadband has never let me down. Reps that actually gave me their personal phone numbers, that they definitely were compassionate. They knew that some of the technical terms they were using I couldn't understand, and they broke them down to me, and I bet this went a long way. Thank you, EPlus Broadband.
For the most reliable drinking water supply at the highest quality, reach for the tap. Our tap water is safe and continues to exceed all government requirements. For more information about our drinking water, visit www.jacksenergy.com/JEACCR.
Move over. It's the law. When approaching work vehicles or crews, move over to create a safety zone. It protects utility workers, law enforcement, firefighters, and emergency personnel. It's not an option. Slow down. It could save a life. Stay safe. Move over.
For 9 years, the READ team has helped over 2,200 second graders read better through coaching and friendships. Students have increased their word recognition by as much as 300%. Reading on grade level opens the door for Google searches, driver's licenses, and career opportunities. Invest 1 hour a week to give our second graders every chance to read on grade level. Go to thereadteam.org to sign up. Three Team, changing our community one word at a time. In partnership with JMCSS, Leaders Education Foundation, and United Way of West Tennessee. But you already knew that because you can read.
Nikki Gano is with us and Hannah Gary, and they were with Habitat for Humanity. A lot of things we can talk about, but we're going to start, I guess, since we're laying plans for the holiday season.
That's right.
With New Year's Eve.
Yeah, this will be, I think this is our sixth year doing a New Year's Eve fundraiser celebration.
Okay, so what's it going to be this year?
A disco party.
Okay. Disco party.
All right.
That's right. It's going to be at Hub City Brew. It'll start at 9 p.m. on the 31st of December, of course. We're going to have a lip sync battle, and if you were there last year, you
sorry to say, last year was the first year you guys did that, wasn't it? And it went over very well.
Yes, yes. So prepare yourselves for more lip sync battle competition.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, are y'all opening up the competition to folks who are interested?
Yes, I think we actually have room for a couple more teams.
Okay.
So if anybody's interested, that is an option. Right now, we have all of our sponsorship opportunities are available, and you can find that on our website at jacksonhabitat.com/NYE.
NYE. Okay, New Year's Eve. And you said you guys are breaking ground on your next house?
We are, yes. We're breaking ground on our next house right now, and that's part of sponsoring this event. Helps us not only we get to celebrate all of the accomplishments throughout the year, how we provide safe and affordable housing throughout our communities, but also it helps us fund those programs going into the next year.
Okay. Let's talk about New Year's Eve in detail for a moment. So we're starting at 9 o'clock.
Yeah.
So how does the evening unfold here?
Yeah, so it starts out with we've got DJ Alpha Whiskey from Memphis. Will be there again this year. She's amazing. She was there last year. And we get to dance and party, and then about 10 o'clock, the lip sync competition kicks off, and you get to vote with your phone. We'll have, like, QR codes. You get to vote for your favorite team. I think at, like, 11 p.m., we announce the winner, and then we dance and celebrate until midnight, and we have a balloon drop and a champagne toast at midnight.
Okay.
Nice.
And so this is the sixth year to do something.
I believe
on
so,
Day.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So it's obviously working out.
Yes. I think we started it 7 years ago and, of course, skipped that one year. Everybody skipped.
Right, yeah. We all had to.
Yes, definitely. So what about tickets? Yeah. How do we get tickets
for this?
Yeah,
you can get those on the same website, jacksonhabitat.com/NYE.
NYE. And tickets are how much?
If you buy them in advance, I think they're $30 each. Yeah, and then if you buy two, so grab a friend, grab your partner, grab somebody to go along with, you get two for $50.
Okay.
And they'll be a little bit higher at the door.
So you can get them at the door if for some reason you don't get them in advance.
Yes, but I recommend getting them in advance. You can also get a VIP sponsorship, so that gets you into the VIP lounge.
And that gets you what?
Yeah, so you'll get a couple drink tickets, there's a private bar over there, and some heavy hors d'oeuvres. And you'll have, like, a groovy lounge space to hang out in.
Okay. Of course. With it being disco, it has to be groovy, right?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Let's go back to Habitat and the work there. This will be how many homes that have been built here in Jackson?
I think this is our 108th. Yeah. I'm pretty sure. Okay. Yeah. And we do, right now, we have applications open for our first-time home buyer program. Do you want to talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, I could talk about that. Right now, applications are open. You can find that information on our website, or you can come by the office and talk to us, and we're happy to help you and, you know, go from there with you. And we also have an open orientation next Monday at 10 o'clock if anybody's interested in that.
And where is that orientation?
That's at our office.
And that's where?
1668. Yeah, 1668 right. North Parkway.
North Parkway. Uh-huh. Okay.
One other thing during the season with decorating all the thrift store.
Oh, yeah.
It's viable and kicking this time of year. Right?
Yes, our resource at the same location, 1668 North Parkway, and we get new product in every day, so there's tons of furniture. There's brand new items such as Delta faucets. We've got appliances, building materials, all kinds of things there.
And the resource where?
Same location. Yep, 1668 North Parkway.
What are the hours of the restore?
Oh, yeah, they are from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Tuesday through Friday.
Okay.
So you can shop late.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
It's good to see you both.
Yeah,
thank
it's
you.
Good to have you guys.
Thanks for
having
us. Look New Year's Eve already.
That's right. Get your tickets.
Got it set up and ready to go.
jacksonhabitat.com/NYE.
That's right.
Okay.
Our special guest today, as far as our musical guest, is going to be in this city the 21st. We'll get details of that
coming
up later.
One day only.
Yeah, one day only. An opportunity to see what you're about to see and hear right now.
That's right.
And that's Memphis Jones.
Well, it's one for the money, a two for the show, a three to get ready now. Go cat go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Do anything, lay off my blue suede shoe. Would you
You can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Do anything that you want to do. Uh-oh, honey, lay off my shoes, or don't you step on my blue suede shoes. You can do anything, just lay off my blue suede shoes. Well, you can burn my house, steal my car, drink my liquor from an old fruit jar. Do anything that you want to do. Uh-oh, honey, lay off my shoes, or don't you step on my blue suede shoes. You can do anything, just lay off my blue suede shoes. Well, blue, blue, blue suede shoe. Blue, blue, blue suede shoe. Yeah, blue, blue, blue suede shoe. Blue, 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 blue suede shoe. Do anything, lay off my blue suede shoe. Well, you can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. Do anything that you want to do. Uh-oh, honey, lay off my shoes, don't you step on my blue suede shoes. Do anything, lay off my blue suede shoes. All right, children, let's rock now. For those of you playing along at the house, this is Carl Perkins from Jackson, Tennessee. One for the money, two for the show, three to get ready now, go cat go, don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Do anything, lay off of my blue suede shoe. Oh yeah, you can do anything, just lay off my blue suede shoes. I want to personally thank you, Jackson, Tennessee, for the great music with Carl Perkins. My name is Memphis Jones, and I'm going to play my little guitar for you until you guys time me out. Oh, yeah. That's what Carl would do. Hey, I see you. Sing with me. A blue, blue, blue suede shoe. A blue, blue, blue suede shoe. Suede shoes, uh-huh, a blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Do anything, lay off my blue suede shoes. Y'all know this was the first million seller in the history of Sun Records. This outsold everything Elvis did, everything Johnny Cash did. Carl Perkins from Jackson, Tennessee, the world's greatest plow hand, biggest influence on the Beatles. Makes me want to just sing it one more time, I guess. Well, blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Oh, blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Oh, blue, blue, blue suede shoes.
From time to time, life may throw us a curveball. Even with the best of efforts, maintaining the essentials like utilities can be difficult. With UtiliCare, you can make a donation to help provide utility assistance to families right here in Jackson. Your contribution makes a difference for those families struggling to pay utility bills. Go online to learn more or donate. JacksEnergy.com/UtiliCare.
The Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation every 2 years does an unannounced on-site review to evaluate every facet of a water system. Inspection includes real-time water sampling, records reviews, personnel training, certification, and more. A perfect score is 599. For the third consecutive inspection covering the last 6 years, the Jackson Energy Authority water system achieved a perfect score. 599, 100%, three consecutive times. That seldom happens, but it happened now at JEA Today.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome back to Six in the City. We'll have more from Memphis Jones coming up later
That's
in this
right.
segment. keeping the music theme going, we're ready to go. Now, George Gooch is with us and David Kyles with the community band, Symphonic Winds, and our jazz orchestra and all this stuff. Good to see you guys.
Good to see
you.
So
we got a show coming up this month.
We sure do. It's November 25th. It's
which will be a Monday.
Monday,
Thanksgiving week,
isn't it? Right before Thanksgiving.
Right before
Monday
Thanksgiving.
Before
Thanksgiving.
Monday before.
So Union University Chapel, 7 p.m., free admission.
Free? Wow.
Yes.
Put the emphasis on it. You can't donate anything, any amount you'd like, but the admission is free.
Yes. We're a fund of the foundation, so any contributions are tax exempt.
All right, so what's going to happen? Symphonic Winds going first?
Right. We'll go first under the direction of conductor Tony Burris. The theme of this program is What's Next? And it's actually a compendium, a combination of American composer music.
Okay.
It's also interesting because one of the pieces is Russian Christmas music, but it's by an American composer. It's a very stirring piece. Now, don't plan on jingle bells on this one, though.
Okay. Oh, we won't get jingle bells. Okay.
And we also have, it's a variety of things. One of them, it's a pretty exciting piece, goes from calm to exciting, Into the Raging River. As you can imagine, there's quite a bit of timpani on that.
Okay, I would say.
And then we have some several others. One is by John Williams, who brought us the music of Star Wars.
Mm-hmm.
And
so
that's
these composers
Lincoln.
Cover what period of time, George?
All over the place.
Okay.
Right.
So a wide range.
Very contemporary stuff to whatever.
Right, right. To a little
All
while
American
back.
Composers.
I think the one of these, the Russian Christmas music, was probably in the 40s when that was written.
Okay.
1940s.
So the Symphonic Winds will play for how long?
Our program will last about 45 to 50 minutes, almost an hour. And then we'll have a short break while the jazz group, it's called the Swing Orchestra, under Mr. David Kyles, who's my guest here.
All right.
Then I'll let him tell you about his portion.
All right.
All right.
So, David, what's ahead then for them?
Well, Steve, we're doing a program we've decided to call Baby Boomer Bombshells.
Okay.
Anyway, this is both the, you know, people that are born between the late 40s and the early 60s, you know, born in that, and there's stuff that will be familiar to them. And some of them are standards, like we're doing a standard Herbie Hancock tune, which is Watermelon Man. And we're also doing one of James Taylor's biggest hits, Fire and Rain. And, you know, a couple, there was some that were done by Bette Midler in the 70s, Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy, and, you know, some things like that. So anyway, we're trying to cover all the bases in that time period that most of us guys like me were born. So,
so who arranged the James Taylor piece then for jazz?
It was a guy, Kenny Wheeler. He was a British trumpet player.
Okay.
He actually did the arrangement we're doing for the Maynard Ferguson Orchestra. So, you know.
Okay.
Oh, wow.
All right. So it sounded like great. It'll last about an hour?
Probably about 45, 50 minutes.
Okay.
Too, so,
okay.
Yeah.
All right.
This is going to be coming up the 25th. It'll be Monday the 25th, the Monday before Thanksgiving. Is
right.
Jim Savage Chapel at Union, and no admission charge for this.
Right.
7 o'clock.
7 p.m.
Doors open at what time?
You can come as early as, say, 6:15 or so. Usually people start showing up around 6:30.
All right.
You do how many concerts a year?
Usually two. Sometimes there's an extra one, but usually there's a fall concert and a spring concert.
Spring concert, all right. So we're looking forward to this. It's gone. So what's next?
Part of it.
That's part of it, yeah.
And then the other part, Baby Boomer Bombshells.
I'm trying to think who all that might include in that time period. We look forward to it.
Yes, most definitely.
Thank you.
It's a great gift to the community, as it's free. You don't need tickets. You don't need anything. Just show up.
Yes, we have a Facebook page and also a web page. Yes, Jackson Area Community Bands. Look that up and it'll
show up. You'll be a donor
there
as well. Yeah, support this cause.
Yes.
It's good to see you guys.
If people are interested in being in the band, can they do that?
Yes, they can contact us. And we have a website, www.jacbinc.com.
Okay. All right.
Or they can send us a message on Facebook.
Oh, perfect.
Well, as I mentioned earlier, coming up this weekend, the 16th at Ford First Baptist, the Jackson Choral Society, and their program is coming up
this
weekend. So we got
That's
music
right. Lots
as
of
we
music.
Head into the season. Speaking of music,
That's right.
We're going back to the main stage. We're welcome once again, Memphis Jones.
Thank you guys for being here.
Well, I taught the weeping willow how to cry. And I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. But the tears I cried for that woman, they're gonna flood you, big river. I'm gonna sit right here till I die. Well, I met her accidentally, St. Paul, Minnesota. And it tore me up every time I heard her drawl, southern drawl. I heard my dream went back downstream, cavorting in Davenport. So I followed you, big river, when you called. Now won't you carry me down to St. Louis, later home down the river? A freighter said she's been here, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. I found her trail in Memphis, but she just walked up the bluff, raised a few eyebrows, and went on down alone. Little Johnny Cash, great friend of Mr. Carl Perkins. That's continuity. See what I did there? Now won't you batten down by Baton Rouge, River Queen, rolling on. Just carry that woman on down to New Orleans, New Orleans. Gone, I've had enough. Dump my blues down in the Gulf. She loves you, big river, more than me. Taught the weeping willow how to cry, cry, cry. And I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. For the tears I cried for that woman, they're gonna flood you, big river. I'm gonna sit right here till I die.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, and thank you, Carl Perkins, for hiring Johnny Cash to be, thank you, Johnny Cash, for hiring Carl Perkins to be your guitar player after Luther passed away in that terrible fire. But that's a better story for another time. Hey, and thank you so much for having me here today. Oh, stop.
Every 3 years, the American Public Power Association recognizes public power companies that demonstrate proficiency in reliability, workforce development, safety, and system improvement. The recognition, RP3. The highest level RP3 is the Diamond RP3. In 2023, JA's Electric Division received the Diamond RP3 Award for the 8th consecutive time. This never happened before, but it's JEA today.
Every 2 seconds, someone in the U.S. needs blood. Lifeline Blood Services provides blood to 17 hospitals and 12 AirVac services in 20 counties. To make your donation, you can come to one of our 2 locations today.
I don't remember how it started.
Start to that.
Our back and forth. It always came back. You probably don't remember what you told me.
That was perfect.
But I heard every word.
Welcome back to Six in the City. Going to detour from music for a moment and get into the written word.
That's right.
Do the right thing, Kevin. W-R-I-T. Former City Council Member Ernest Brooks II, I think, that brought this.
Yes,
into this city.
From the city of Jackson.
And Annette Graves is with us, and then Charlotte Mount is with us, and Josiah is with us as well. We'll talk to them and get lined up on their work. But you picked this up how many years ago now?
2 years ago, okay. I became chair of the program here in Jackson.
All right.
We're going to our 18th year in the program here. So.
All right, wow. All right, so for those that haven't heard of this, how do you describe this program?
Do the Right Thing is a violence prevention program where students in middle school write ways to prevent violence, how violence has affected their life, and lastly, they write about solutions to prevent youth violence.
Okay. And it's a national program,
It's a national program, right? Where students all over the country take a part in this program.
All right, so students participate here, and then how many are selected to go to D.C.?
We have two students that go to D.C., okay. However, students all across the Jackson-Madison County School District take part in the essay.
Okay.
So who judges and picks the two that go to Washington? How does that work?
We have a panel of judges.
Okay.
The Jackson, Tennessee Alumni Chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, Incorporated, they are the panel of judges.
Okay.
And they judge the essays for us.
Oh, nice.
And the most responsive essays are the ones that get a chance to be in the top 20.
Uh-huh.
And then from the top 20, two are selected to go to Washington, D.C.
Okay.
Right. Now, we have two of the winners here that went to Washington, D.C. last year. One of those is Charlotte Mountain and then Josiah Young. And we're going to hear from Charlotte this segment. Josiah will be with us. Well, he's here. We're going to hear his reading.
That's right.
So this work that you put together, okay?
Yes, sir.
Well, what started that with you? What were you trying to say here?
I just really was excited to have my voice heard. People my age don't get that opportunity every day, so I just wanted to jump
okay.
at the moment.
And what grade are you in, Charlotte?
I'm in eighth grade.
Eighth grade, okay.
Eighth grade, and she went to see. Art, do you mind sharing your work with us?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Violence has been a part of society for an exceptionally long time. It has torn families, friends, and communities apart. It has created hate and loss in a world that has enough to deal with already. It is intimidation, brutality, and savagery. Youth violence is a mini version of that. Youth violence is what leads to adult violence, and it leads to violence in adults. So we need to learn about the causes of youth violence and what we can do to prevent it. Violence has affected my life in a few different ways. I see violence at school when someone is intimidating someone else through words or threats. I also see it through fights or on the news. This exposure to violence has affected me by realizing the harshness of the world. I have come to understand that the world that we live in is corrupt and filled with violence. It is a world that seems helpless against growing hate. Even though I have a wider mindset, I know that there is still a lot of good in the world and that I can make a difference. Youth violence can come in many forms and for varied reasons. The most common causes of youth violence are previous or violent behavior, being the victim of physical abuse, exposure to violence in the home and or community, being the victim of bullying, exposure to violence in media, use of drugs or alcohol, presence of firearms in home, combination of stressful family socioeconomic factors, breakup, single parenting, unemployment, loss of support from extended family. This list shows a broad idea of main causes, but main causes are bad home situations, drugs, and early exposure to firearms. A negative home situation can cause a child to have a negative attitude at an early age. Drugs are the next step down the road, then firearms. If no one intervenes, then the child will go through this chain reaction and will have a challenging time breaking habits of violence. We can stop this violence in many ways. Young individuals can choose not to participate in groups that threaten others. A neighborhood can have cameras in place to watch crime and violence rates. A school can have extra security and be on the watch for those who need to be counseled through bullying. After-school programs provide opportunities for youth to strengthen their social and academic skills and become involved in school and community activities to expand their pro-social experience and relationships. These approaches also address key risk and protective factors for youth violence by helping provide supervision during critical times of the day, such as from 3 to 6 p.m., when youth crime and violence peak. This is a particularly effective way to prevent violence from happening, especially after school when kids feel more freedom to do whatever they want. These are just a few of many ways to prevent violence. I am encouraged by this topic to help stop violence. Violence is horrible and needs to be stopped. We can limit violence altogether by focusing on stopping youth violence. When youth violence rates have diminished, then the total violence rates will go down too. This is because when nonviolent children and teenagers grow up, they know that violence is bad and how to prevent themselves from being involved in violent acts and movements. And this bad chain of violence breaks, and a good chain of peace and compassion begins. We can learn from violence in our own lives and take steps to peace of mind so that we can help others get over the scars of violence so that this world will be full of hope and prosperity. So I ask, will you break this chain and start a new one of love and kindness?
at Charlotte Mount.
Nice.
When we come back, we will hear from Josiah Young. We'll continue our conversation with Annette Graves. Do the right thing on this Six in the City.
Want to receive account information via text? When you enroll in JA Alerts, you can. Text to get a bill balance, due date, set a payment extension, receive an outage notification, reply to report an electric outage. Text JOIN, J-O-I-N, text JOIN to 53248, 53248. Cell phone number must be current and attached to your JA account. Visit jacksenergy.com/textalerts for more information.
At Southern Family Dentistry, we offer dental treatment for your entire family. We have the latest 3D digital x-ray system. We offer implants, veneers, teeth whitening, and all the other normal services you receive at the dental office. We have two offices, one in Milan and one in Jackson, and EPlus broadband telephone services allows us to connect both of those offices. It doesn't matter which office the patient calls, we have the ability to speak to that patient at either location.
We're focused on Do the Right Thing, which is an anti-violence writing program that is a national competition and features. Annette Graves is with us, who coordinates this program here in Jackson, Madison County. We heard the last segment from Charlotte Mount, and we're going to hear from Josiah Young in this segment. He was at West Bemis last year when he wrote this, and then she's at Northeast Middle. Now, these works of theirs are published.
Yes, they're published. They're published authors. We have a local book that we published for the top 20. And so since they're national ambassadors, we have a national book that's been inducted into the Library of Congress in Washington, D.C.
Well, okay. That's impressive.
So that's all part of this.
You can say you're a published author, right?
Yeah. What happens when you go to D.C.? What happens on that trip?
They have various activities they participate in. Would you like to share some things you all do in D.C.?
In D.C., we got a hotel, and it was a whole lot of other kids from around the nation that wrote basically about youth violence. And we all got together, and we had it was a whole lot of experiences. It was life-changing for some people.
Okay. Is that your first trip to D.C.?
Yes, ma'am. That was my first time ever going to D.C.
Okay, and yours?
Yes, it was my first time, too.
Okay.
Okay, exciting.
That is exciting.
Well, Josiah, let's hear your word. This is Josiah Young. Do the right thing.
Youth violence happens every day. It's harmful actions caused by young adults that impact people of all ages and races. This violence causes youth not to be able to pursue many things in life that could lead to good employment or a job they want to do in the future. Instead, it leads to juvenile or sometimes death. No matter how you view it, there is no upside to youth violence. It hurts everyone involved. Last year at my school, there was a threat to kill some other students at the school. It scared everyone and their parents. Some people did not come. This happens in schools across the nation every day. There are kids who come to school to harm others with guns, knives, and their fists. According to Campus Safety Magazine Online, a study of the last 52 years in schools say since 1970, there have been 2,057 incidents involving the discharge of a firearm on a school property, and 680 people have died. This does not include fights and knives. Who goes to school to be killed or harmed by other youth like them? Do you want to know why young people are violent? Some people may teach their kids to be violent without realizing it. We do what we see and hear from our parents. If your parents are angry, rowdy, violent, and do not think clearly, you will most likely act and think like them. Younger people also think it is cool to watch and reenact things they see other young people doing, like fights, gangs, and many other violent things. These things are all over social media. Violent video games also may raise the urge for a kid to act violently. The school shooters in Columbine played Hollow, which is a game, which is a video shooting game. Another reason youth are violent is because they do not talk about their anger. They keep it bottled up, and when it comes out, it can be violent. Sometimes they think they are angry. Sometimes they are angry because they keep getting bullied about the same things or bad things at home. I know that not everyone believes it exists, but I believe the devil puts very violent ideas in our children's minds to make them start acting violent and aggressive at a very young age. This can really happen if they have not a lot of free time with nothing to do or not good people to hang around. Some people do not have adult role models like my coach to hold them accountable and teach them right from wrong. There are ways we can stop youth violence. First, adults need to listen to kids when they are upset or angry or have problems. This stops the thoughts that lead to youth violence. Parents can also be a good example or show their children what it looks like to live a nonviolent lifestyle. We are watching them. Our parents need to know what we are watching and listening on our devices. We need sports and other interactive activities to keep our minds busy. When I'm playing my trumpet or basketball, I do not have time to be angry or violent. The last thing kids need are adults, like my coaches, to have a positive influence on us. With enough listening, watching, activities, and positive role models, we can end youth violence.
Very good.
Josiah Young's work in Charlotte Mount prior to that. Congratulations on this.
Yes.
Yeah. So how many students overall participate then in this?
We have over 250 essays submitted from the Jackson Master County School District this year.
Right. Wow. Yes. And you said this book is published here. People can get it?
We have a local book published here. Then contact me with my name, Annette Graves, number 5 and the number 8, at gmail.com.
Okay.
AnnetteGraves58 at gmail.com.
Correct.
It's good to see you both.
Thank you so much. Congratulations on being the published author. Not many people can say that, right? Absolutely. Good for you.
We're going to take another important step. When we come back, we'll be talking to Memphis Jones. Is that right?
I think
that's coming. But right now, we're going back to the main stage.
We're going to hear from Memphis Jones.
Then we'll talk to him and hear from him again.
That's right.
As we continue,
Six in the City.
Otis Redding. Sitting in the morning sun. I'll be sitting watching the ships roll in. I'll be watching all the way again. So I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Left my home in Georgia, headed for the Frisco Bay. I've had nothing to live for, and look like nothing gonna come my way. So I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. And everything still remains the same. I can't do what dead people tell me to do, so I guess I remain the same. I'm just gonna sit here resting my bones, but this loneliness won't leave me alone. 2,000 miles I roam, and just to make this dock my home. Lord knows I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. It looks like nothing's gonna change, and everything still remains the same. I can't do what did people tell me to do, so I guess I remain.
2,000 miles I roam, and just to make this dock my home.
Surprise!
Hi, I'm here to ask the people of Jackson to be a part of a groundbreaking program, 4 Minute City.
Every minute you don't get help after a sudden cardiac arrest, your chance of survival decreases by 10%.
That's why Friends of Heart and the Jackson Fire Department have created a care team.
A group of everyday citizens trained, equipped, and ready to save lives in our community.
Please call this number or visit our website.
Together, we can save lives.
Tired of internet that leaves you waiting and monitoring your usage with extra fees? Switch to EPlus Broadband from the Jackson Energy Authority for fiber optic internet with the fastest speeds to keep everyone connected. Enjoy being online as much as you want without worrying about extra fees or data usage limits. Perfect for when you need to download and upload large files, stream videos, or use your favorite video conferencing app. EPlus Broadband, fastest internet, no data caps, no slowdowns, no worries.
So, I'm kind of new here, but I've noticed a trend. My human does this funny thing where she goes around and gets all my toys, and then she hides them in that basket by the door. You know, but it's always the same basket, and it's always in the same place. And then she acts so surprised when I find them, but, you know, she's putting them in the same basket. Again. It's like, hello? That's where you put it last time. You were the worst at hide-and-go-seek.
Welcome back to the Six in the City, just in the nick of, she's a runner, new show.
I don't know if I'm on the right side or not. I won't get right here. How about that?
Well, I don't have a good side, so you just pick whatever you want.
Well, I didn't want to get on the guitar side because I don't play guitar, so I'll let you do the music.
So we've moved over to the main stage to talk to Memphis Jones. First of all, you got a show coming up here next week.
I do, and I'm so glad to be participating up here. It's going to be a wonderful community event. There's some tickets still available. It's going to be a great night. It's going to be a fun
It's going to be the 21st at 7:30 at the Doubletree.
At the Doubletree Hotel, that's right. This will be my debut at the Jackson Doubletree. I can't wait.
All right, you better watch out.
They give you free tickets, cookies.
The tickets are $10 each, and it's going to the 30th Separate Armored Brigade Association. So what is this? Yeah.
Well, this is a group of veterans that support one another. You know, Jackson, Tennessee has an incredible community of veterans. It really is amazing, and there's how much notoriety it has. And this is just a way to support and to bring this community and to keep this community together. As a lot of these men who served in foreign wars are getting older and aging, you know, there's not as much community support, or at least not as much publicity. So this is just a way to sort of remind this great city how much it loves and values its veterans and how much those veterans value the city.
Memphis, how can people get tickets?
That's a great question.
Terry Sanders, I think you can write Terry Sanders at 368 Mead Melissus Road, 38301.
Or you can get tickets at the door.
Or you get tickets at the door.
Yeah, let's do that.
That's the easiest, right?
$10 at the door.
Absolutely, yeah. And just for the record here, it is so exciting. I was so glad when this came together and my calendar was open, and you know, I stay as busy as I can, you know, just trying to make a living as a preaching troubadour out there. Right. But to get to come here back to Jackson, and you know, I love y'all so much, and Steve, I'm so pleased to be in your company.
Man, it's great to see you.
I really admire you so much. But it's going to be a great, great time. It's going to be world-class entertainment and a very, very low cost, but for a really, really worthy cause.
It's one night only, so
Thursday the 21st, 7:30 at the Dover. Mm-hmm. Where can we see you in Memphis now? I know you're preaching.
That's right. I'm a senior pastor at Cornerstone Church on Witten Road in Memphis, Tennessee. And our services are Sunday at 10:30 a.m.
All right. Very good.
That's amazing. But I also have my stand at B.B. King's since 2012. I've been proud to be a featured act there on Mondays and Fridays.
Mondays and Fridays at B.B. King's on Beale Street.
So if you want to see him, get to Memphis.
So good to have you here.
Steve, the pleasure is all mine.
Definitely. We always love having you here.
Thanks for inviting me.
We're going to get out of the way and let this man do what he does best.
Are we going to do one more little song here?
Memphis Jones. Move this chair.
Why don't we do the number one that never was? You can look up all the details on Wikipedia. This is Elvis Presley, Burning Love.
Lord,
I feel my temperature rising. Higher, higher, burning through to my soul. Yeah. Girl, 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 you're gonna set me on fire. My way is waving. I don't know which way to go. Yeah. But your kisses lift me higher. Like the sweet sound of choir. Like my morning sky high with burning love. Whoa, I feel my temperature rising. Have me a flaming. Must be 109. Yeah. Burning, burning, burning. And nothing can cool me. Nothing can cool me. I just might turn into smoke, but I feel fine. Yeah, because your kisses lift me higher, like a sweet sound of a choir. You light my morning sky high with burning love. Now it's coming closer, flames are now reaching my body. Please, won't you help me? I feel like I'm slipping away. Oh, yeah. Now it's hard to breathe. You know my chest is a heaving. Lord Almighty, I'm burning a hole where I lay. Yeah, because your kisses lift me higher. Like the sweet sound of a choir. You light my morning sky high with burning love. Burning love. Burning love. Burning love. Burning love. Burning love. Ow! I'm just a hunger, hunger, burning love. 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 Well, I'm just a hunger, hunger, burning love. You know I'm just a hunger, hunger, burning love. Yes, I'm just a hunger, hunger, burning love. I'm just a hunger, hunger.
Fantastic drum solo inserted here, and then the big finished. Pow! Burning Love by Elvis Presley, his last top 10 hit. Hey, thank you so much, Jackson, Tennessee.
That's my neighbor, Joe. Hey, Joe.
Hey, John.
Joe's about to make a big mistake. Hey, Joe, I think it might be a good idea to call 811 to have the utilities marked before you start digging?
I'm not digging very deep. It's no big deal.
No big deal.
Dad, the TV's out. Internet, too.
Remember, safe digging always starts with a free call to 811. Oh, what a knucklehead.
Do you love sports? Then you should know about STEM. Because maximizing nutrition, analyzing peak muscle performance, calculating the perfect shot, and more are all made possible by science, technology, engineering, and math. In fact, there are more careers than ever in sports science. So if you have a passion for sports, then think about getting involved in STEM and improve everyone's game on and off the field. Get inspired at shecanstem.com.
The family's visit to the forest inspired a beautiful question. Mother, mother, am I a tree? You tell me to stand tall. You tell me to stay rooted. I think I am a tree. My child, of course you are. But what kind of tree will you be? The kind to hug or the kind to climb? Doesn't matter what you choose, so long as you choose to be a tree that's kind.
Make the forest part of your story at a park near you. Find one at discovertheforest.org.
We've got a tribute to veterans coming up. Before we get there, save the date, November the 19th, in Northside Church, a night of giving hope for the Hope Recovery Center. So put that on the 19th.
That's right. If you're a fan of Clay Walker, he's going to be at Williams Auditorium Friday, the November the 15th at 7:30. And then also, too, there's a St. Jude fundraiser. It is on the move for St. Jude. It's an off-road truck and Jeep scavenger hunt. It is $20 per off-road vehicle. It's 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. It's coming up November the 16th at Southside High School at Hartsbridge Road. Okay. So that should be something interesting, but it's a fundraiser for St. Jude. So. Right.
And a reminder, once again, the Veterans Parade is this coming Saturday, and that'll be at 11 o'clock starting in downtown Jackson at the Civic Center. So we'll see you there. Speaking of veterans, this is Veterans Week.
Veterans Day was yesterday.
And we have some people from this company, from the Jackson Energy Authority, that have served this nation in a very, very special way.
That's right.
We want you to know about them. We'll see you next week for more Six in the City.
Say this.